Hello everybody, Alex here from Snake on Exotics. It was a little bit fuzzy headed today. We had a couple of bevvies last night, but we're still here, we're still kicking, so we're gonna get all the jobs done today. Maybe some back video from yesterday, but I don't think there will be, but we're going through, get all the jobs done, and then yeah, fingers crossed we have a good day, and I shall see you in a bit.
So we'll have a quicker check on our new arrivals. I think that's what we do first. So we got to check on the new tortoise, and we got to check on the two new chameleons, and we got to check on the bird poo frogs, and we got to check on who else came with them. The crabs. We got to go see if the crabs have survived the night in the gar tank. So we check on everybody, and then we go around and do our little jobs for today.
Hello mate, how are you doing this morning? Enjoying your afternoon in Snake Island Exotics, are you, sir? So, he's doing really well. Yesterday, which was really nice. How are you doing, buddy? You enjoying your vines?
Yes, we likes the vines. So, we've got to go through, we've got to check all the drippers, because I think they've run low now from this morning. So we've got to empty all the water bowls, we've got to fill all the drippers, we've got to turn the UV lights on, which aren't on at the moment because we've just came in. So we'll turn all the UV lights on, we'll do the waters, and we'll chuck some food in for them as well. Who's good lads, eh? Who's hiding in the bush? I've got to hide in the bush. He's looking at me. I've got to hide in the bush.
Morning, mate. How you doing? Do you want to try something different today? I got wormies in the bottle. Look. Want to try one of the wormies? They're in there, look. No, you don't want to try a worm?
You can't see them, can you? You can't see them in there.
Oh, look. You're biting the box, but not what's in the box. No? Okie dokie then.
Oh, I might get the tweezers, actually, see if he wants it with tweezer feeding.
Oh, you had that. Want to try another one, buddy?
Oh, he's still got that one.
You bit it in the middle. It's like the most awkwardest way to eat it.
He's a good boy. Yum, 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 yum.
Nearly finished? Want another one?
Whoa, yes he does. Bit of a varied diet for him. Not him having locusts and crickets all the time. I'm going to get some veg in there for him as well, so we can have a bit of veg. You loves a good munch, don't you, buddy? Yummy. What a good boy. Yes. Well, we have one more after that, eh? What do you reckon? Fancy one more? You missed it. Good boy. What a good lad, eh? We'll leave you to it, and we'll give you some other bugs later on, eh?
Let's see if we can find the bird poo tree frogs. Bird poo, mossy frogs. They're not tree frogs, they're mossy frogs. So, I think I can see one, but we might have to find the other one. Ram you lads. There he is. There's one of the bad boys. There he is. Right at the back.
Looks like a little bird poo. There he is. Da-da-da-da. So there's one. Now where is his buddy is the question. His buddy is right at the front. There he is. How'd you do it? Come on, let's have a good look at you. There he is, hiding in the bottom. Little bird poo frog. I don't know why they're mossy frogs. The mossy frogs actually look like they're covered in moss. It's supposed to be a slight variant of them, I'm assuming. But I will do me a little bit of research on them. I've never had them in the shop before, so we always have a good research on them. And then we've got the new soul cutter tortoise. And then we've got the crabs we've got to find. We've got to see if they're on Crab Island or they've moved away. I forgot to say yesterday as well, when they dropped off the chameleons and the tortoise, They collected the male and took him back because as he wasn't doing very well, and I phoned him up and they have had problems with a couple of them having I think they described it as like a tummy parasite. So they've got the treatments and all that at the suppliers. So they said they're gonna take him back, recuperate him, give him the right stuff, and fingers crossed that build him back up. And you never know, might be able to have him back. So we've just got the female at the moment, so she's got the old tank to herself. So I have to admit, I do love all this big bush. So really like this tank. So we've got to still got to check on the new tortoise, still got to check on the crabs. We might do the crabs first. So the crabs, they're on, we've released them onto Crab Island. So we've got to see if they've stayed on Crab Island or they've decided to move to different parts of the tank. This is Crab Island. I believe we've got one crab still on Crab Island. Anybody else in the cracks? And there's just one crab left on Crab Island. We'll have a good look around everywhere else and see if we can spot where they've moved to. Oh, turn me light off. There we go. Can we spot the crabs? So we know we've at least got one accounted for. Let's check the back of the woods, see if there's anybody around here. Oh, hello Mr. Crab. So that one's moved into the woods. So he's travelled all the way from there, across the gap, into the wood, and he's quite happy down there. You can see the red of him. There he is. So there's two. So we're still missing two. Where could they be? We only found two, but you can tell they can hide in this sort of area. So I'm not worried that I'm missing two. They're just hid somewhere else. A little bit murky today because I had the waterfall stopped. And then while I was fixing it, the whole lot fell down, so I had to rebuild it all. So a lot of the plants, the aquatic plants that were going up there, a lot of them have gone now. I've took them away. So I want to find some new plants we can put there that will survive a bit better. So let's see if we can see the new tortoise. Hello, little man. How are you doing this morning? Hey? You been having fun with Sir Diggs-a-lot? I know he's a bad influence, Sir Diggs-a-lot. Yeah, you've been out partying with Sir Diggs a lot, have you? You can see by the look on your face. You feel just as hungover as I do, don't you? Yes, you do. I don't know, out partying with Sir Diggs a lot till God knows what time in the night. I don't know, he's a nice lad, though. He's very, very small, though. Very, very small. We're not talking to you. Stop being nosy. Really, really nice tortoise. I've really come along to him quite a bit now. So I've never seen a proper baby one this small. I've seen like some good sized ones, but never one this small. He's so cute. I know, we'll feed you in a minute. Just be patient. God. So he's a nice little lad. So he's an African spear-fied tortoise or Sulcata tortoise. So needs a little bit different care to some of the other ones. He needs a lot hotter. He needs a little bit of humidity as well. And same food and stuff like that, but sometimes he might need a little bit of extra protein just because he's going to get a big tortoise. He's a lovely little boy. Oh, I'm off. I'm going. I'm having it. I'm going. I've been trying to find the right tank so we can separate the European eyed lizards. So the thing is, I'm struggling to find the right one with the right lights, the right heat, and all stuff like that. So what I'm thinking of doing is doing separate feeding. So what we do is we'd put the choose from. So we'll take the box out. Oh, and we'll have to feed the beardies because the beardies are getting jealous. So we'll feed the beardies next. So let him go around. How many's in there? Well, he's had two. There's six more. So he's not going to eat all of them. Let's release him in here. I think this is a good compromise for not having a spare tank. There we go. So they're still going to get nice feeds, and we haven't got to worry about fighting, which was my main concern, because I don't want anybody getting damaged. It doesn't have to be damaged. There we go. So what we do, we'll get some, when he's finished, we've got like two or three left, we'll take them out, and then we have to wait for the female to come out and eat these ones. Oh, there she is. She's coming. There she is, look, munching away. So she'll come out now and munch as many as she wants, and then hopefully we won't have any fighting then. How many you got left? You got one in your mouth and you're still trying to eat one. Look at you, you're so greedy. He's not, but it tastes so good, it tastes so good. I want more in my mouth. Just get it all in my mouth. See, it's fighting back now, it's fighting back. You got too many in your mouth. You've only got it by the leg. Do you need a hand? Come here. Come on, let me help you. No? Okay, enjoy your food. So we have found a home for the normal bearded dragon. So the citrus one is still looking for a home, but the normal one, he's coming with us to the school on Monday, and he's going to go live at the school. So the school is they've got a good range of animals. And they're having, they've decided to have a beardy now. So he's going in, they've got a 4 foot tank, but they split it in half. So, and as he gets older, they can make it bigger and bigger and bigger. So they want me to come and inspect it all, bring the dragon with me and all that. So me and Meg will go down Monday, bring the dragon, check on all the tanks, check all the other stuff. I'm going to have some, it'll be two of the kids were coming round with me. And I'll be telling them about it and all stuff like that. But yeah, we're not going to do a big talk because we can't, it's because of the virus. So they can't have, all the kids are in little bubbles. So I don't know, maybe 10, 15, a class bubble. And then, so they found two kids that are in the same bubble and their parents are teachers at the school. So they've got all the permission sorted, so we've got no problem at all with that. So so yeah, we'll go over there Monday, take the darker beardy, and we'll have a good day, hopefully. Should we put you back in? There he is. What a good lad. And no fighting, so I'm happy with that. So I'm going to go around now, get all the stragglers that haven't been eaten. So you can come with me. Yes, you can. So, boom, you can go in there. That's everybody. So that's them fed. And we had no fighting. That's going to be the best scenario for what we got to do at the moment. Because, I mean, I could put him in another tank, but he's going to have no UV for 3 or 4 days till I get the light ordered. And stuff like that. So I'm not happy about that. I want to keep them in perfect condition with like the UVs and all stuff like that. So yeah, I'm glad that worked out well. So there's no fighting. Everyone's had a feed. So yeah, I'm happy about that. I think we're ready for some more fish in the marine display. So I've been umming and ahhing about it, and I don't want to put any of the new ones in yet because they're still settling in. So I think out of the ones that we've had in for a while, we've got the chromies and we've got the two clowns. I think those would be the best scenario for in the tank. And I've been thinking I'm going to put the two clowns in, I think. So we're going to have the two little clowns, two normal ones. They can go in and then they'll be quite docile and chilled out. And they're quite small at the moment, so they won't affect us putting anything else in down further on down the line. So I think we should start catching some clowns and get them in the tank and see what they look like. Okay, so we've got the clowns, we've got them in a little bag in there ready. So now we've just got to try and catch them. Come on, mate. In the net, what a good lad. So, well, this is a bit awkward doing it with one hand. So we grab the fish in the net so he doesn't jump out. We turn it over and we gently let him into the bag. So there we go, there's one. Now we've got to catch the other one. Come on mate, do the same thing. That's a good lad. And we brings him up. Whoop, and we're in the net. Look at that, nice and chilled. And we do the same thing, hold it up, grab the net, twist it over, drop him into the bag. There we go. Two fish, nice and easily caught, no stress. So we take them over and we plonk them into here. I'm going to need my other hand to open the tank. So there we go. We've got our clowns in the tank, so we're going to give them a dunk to start them acclimating. You see the blurriness in the bag? That's the different amounts of salt and water mixing together. So that's how you know it's acclimating. So we do that 3 or 4 times over about 10, 15 minutes. And then the temperature, we don't have to do the temperature because they're in the same building. So the tank should be exactly the same temperature. We've just got to mix the waters. But I think they're going to look the part in there swimming around. Ain't you lads? You're going to look great. Going to look great. Hey then guys, you're all ready. So we're going to release them out nice and slow. Come on lads, One more. There you go, how's that? Oh, I'm making a mess, I'm making a mess.
Hello guys, how are you liking the new tank, eh?
You looked the part, didn't you? So we've got the two clowns, we've got the cleanest rim, we've got the canary Blenny, who likes to live at the bottom. He's in that little cave. And then we've got the hermit crab, who is hiding. Yes, definitely hiding, because I can't see him. But he's about. Somewhere, maybe, hopefully. He's in here. We'll find him later on tomorrow, today or tomorrow if we can see him. But I think they're going to be happy as Larry. So I'm going to do round, we go round and we've got to feed the fish now. So we give them a feed and see if they want to have some dinner. But we'll feed some of the other ones as well as feeding our new little clowns. So we've got to do something different for these ones. So this is the eel. So he has a lance fish. And then we've got the big puffers. They have cockles. And then everyone else just gets a mix of all the stuff. So there's brine shrimp, krill, and moises as well. So they get a nice little mix. So we're going to go through and do the eel first, then the puffers, then we do everybody else.
So I think he's down here somewhere. He's in that crack. I don't know where his head is. Come on, buddy. Where's your head at? Where's your head at? Oh. And off he goes. What a good lad.
These are the cockles. So what we do is we open it up for him. You can see all the meat inside. So, should have opened this first, shouldn't I, really? Oh, we're going to get in. Oh, I'm in. Whoop.
You hungry, lads? Oh, I dropped it. It's down there, lads. I'll get you another one.
Get him another one. Once they get used to it, I'll get them to open it up themselves.
Ow, he bit me. Ow. Oh, I'm dropping that. Ow, he bit me with his beak. Oh, I didn't expect him to bite me. Could he munch in it? We give him the last one, he's found that one now. But you got to share with your mate. Got to watch it, because he just bit me. And they got beaks they have, so they take chunks out of this shell, they would. Yeah, lads. There we go, you have that, there we go. Sharing's caring, ain't it, boys? Got nice big fat ones, that's what we want. So these lads are a little bit small for them. So these ones will have the krill and all the stuff like everybody else. I love that little puffer so much. He's so cute. So cute. So I think that's them done. But we'll come back to give some for the lionfish. You ready, lads? Oh, you already know, don't you? Good lads, first seconds in the tank and they're eating. Shows we acclimated them right, shows they weren't stressed, and even shrimpy was going to grab some.
I'll put a little bit extra in there so we make sure it gets down to the canary blenny. Yeah, that should be plenty. You can shut it back up now. Everybody can have their dinner.
Okay then everybody, I thought we'd mix it up and say goodbye in a different spot. So I hope you've enjoyed the video. We got most of our jobs done today. We did separate feeding for the European oil lizards, which went really well, so I'm going to do that from now on. We had a look at the tortoise, the new chameleons, we fed the marines, we fed the puffers, and we had the new clowns in the display. So I think we had a really good day. I think tomorrow I'm going to do a certain animal care on that certain animal, I think we're going to do tomorrow. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe, comment and share for me. If you would like to watch another video, should be a box there. If you want to watch a playlist, should be up there. If you want to subscribe to the channel, should be up there. So I'll see you in the future. Bye.